Was that in your apartment where you owned four apartments?
Yeah, in the building where I was renting four apartments.
Why didn't you just get a house? Like, what's your thought? Like, you're like, I got an apartment, and then you wanted four more?
He was compartmentalized. Like, one was party, one was skate, one was business, and the other one was more like your
house. Then the other one was for my assistant.
Yeah. Did you ever go over there?
Oh, yeah, all the time.
Do you remember any fun times over there?
Lots of fun times.
It's great.
It was all about fun times. It's like, why wouldn't it not be fun? You had a full skate park in one of them. That was awesome. And then just, yeah, like bong hits and beer and whippets and shit everywhere. Video games and just like
rad
music, weird people coming over.
So did you rent those all at once, or did you get one and you're like, we should get another one?
I kept adding them.
I remember that. Yeah, you had like, I thought it was crazy you had two and then three, like four.
Yeah.
I like that one time when you like bashed in the wall to your neighbors.
Yeah. Yep.
Oh, yeah. Well, just the people that were over there.
That happened. Just imagine if you're the other guy.
I know, dude.
That must have been crazy.
Yeah. Was that your only neighbor that ever complained? Like, being next to the skate park would have been terrible, I would think.
Well, next to the skate park was like some Russian hookers. Okay. They had like a little prostitution deal going on, so they weren't like trying to complain.
They were looking
about
for some noise coverage anyway.
Right. Yeah. And like the other side of the skate park apartment had like a stairwell, and underneath was the parking garage. So that one was like pretty well situated.
Nice.
Yeah, I feel like I would want to be next to the Whippets one, because you'd probably be, you're just doing this and not making much noise, you know?
No, well, the Whippet one was a problem. Like, and I did get complaints from the family. It was just this, like, foreign family. The dad would come over, like, in his boxer shorts, and he had his family, and he was like, my family's trying to sleep, and the walls are shaking. Please. I actually went back to that, to the early in sobriety, I went back to the building and I said, hey, you know, like I had this family next to me and like, I just want to like, you know, pay a month of their rent just because, but they had already moved out.
Mm. Did you ever find them?
I did not.
Man, too bad you can't reach out to them.
I would love to. I would love to.
That whole apartment,
if you're watching this, like,
era of your life, like, call us. You just want to go revisit it and make things right.
Yeah, well, dude, now we're going to have like, oh, dude, I was the family. Dude, I've had that experience.
Do you remember who they are, though?
No. Oh, really? I only remember in the middle of the night, I'm all fucked up. The guy's in his boxer shorts begging me, like, to make the walls stop shaking.
Oh, my God,
yeah,
dude.
It was really bad.
Wow.
Yeah, dude. Guess what? I have the number 30 ranked hot sauce on all of Amazon. It's called Steve-O's Hot Sauce for Your Butthole. And if you go on Amazon and type in Steve-O's Hot Sauce for Your Butthole and order yourself a bottle, you'd be really helping me. Because right now we're ranked number 30 on all of Amazon. And if you buy a bottle, we might go up the ladder. And that would mean a lot. So please get on Amazon and buy Steve-O's Hot Sauce for Your Butthole. Yeah. Yeah, dude.